everyone, this is Ovi from Ovi Innovation Outlets, and I am here with Monique today, and we're going to check out a game called Fireworks Mania. Now, as you know, today is New Year's Eve, but the weather outside is cold, it's rainy, it's not exactly very inviting to go out there. So I found this game on Steam, looked kind of interesting. You can play around with different types of fireworks, make your own little shows. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe this could be kind of cool to use as an alternative to actually going outside. I know there's probably not much you can do to make it better other than actually going outside, which is, you know, the real thing. You can't really beat it. But nevertheless, we want to check this out to see what we can actually do in this game. So just give us a few moments. We're going to jump in here and we're going to check out Fireworks Mania. Okay, so let's start our game here. Now this game generally uses a mouse and keyboard to control it, but I am using a keyboard emulator to use a controller for today's demonstration. So let's get started here. So right now the game is still early access, and they currently have a town and a ranch available for the map that we can use. So let's start with the town today. I haven't done the ranch yet, but the town looked kind of cool last time I tried it out.
So you know how to use these controls?
I think I do. It only has a few different controls available right now, so I mapped them onto the controller, but there's something I forgot. We can change that later on in the actual software. I'm using a software called Joy2Key, I believe is the name of it. It's shareware. It works pretty well for giving you controls where you normally don't have a controller available. So, you know, you have pretty much full functionality, provided that you have mapped all the keys correctly, and I think I have done that today. Okay, Nick, so this is the map. It's a town. So you can walk around here and you can kind of pick where you want to start leaving your fireworks. There is a convenience store down over here, the 24/7 convenience store.
Can you get on top of the buildings?
Yeah, I haven't tried. So there's a house over here. I don't know whose house this is. No, you know, normally kids don't try this at home. You don't want to walk into a stranger's house and start lighting fireworks, but this is just a game. So, you know, why not? Let's go in here and check it out, right?
How do you know it's not going to electrocute you?
Well, you know, fireworks thankfully generally don't use electricity. Of course, you are playing
house.
With fire.
The house! How do you know they don't have it?
Some kind of like a booby trap or some burglar alarm or something.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know that, but I kind of figured, you know, I wouldn't expect that in this game, since you just kind of, I'm already breaking stuff. Since you are just sort of, you know, playing around with fireworks, I don't think we need to be concerned about being electrocuted, at least not yet. You know, of course, when you're playing around here in the kitchen with fire and electricity, things could be potentially an issue.
Like this food, or can you pick anything up?
Let me see. So, as far as our tools are concerned, we have an ignite tool, our lighter. We have a physics tool where we can move and rotate objects. Fuse connection tool, so we want to light or kind of connect multiple fireworks together. We can actually do that with this tool.
Cool.
And just have our empty hands here. I don't think we can do anything, unfortunately. Until I do more research, I'm going to assume that we can't grab a lot of things, so, well, hey, never mind. The physics tool does allow us to move stuff around.
Apparently drop stuff on the floor.
Yeah, so we can definitely make a mess. That's always easy to do. The cleanup, I'm sure, is not quite as easy. But anyway, before we get too carried away, let's remember why we are actually here today, and that is to actually light fireworks. I don't think we want to light fireworks in the house, even though that does seem kind of interesting. Maybe we'll save that for later as a finale. So let's go back outside and find a place where we want to do our fireworks. So I don't see any traffic, any cars, so we probably could do them out here in the streets.
Is this town abandoned?
It looks pretty empty right now. So we have the whole town to ourselves, which is kind of nice, a little sandbox for us to play around in here.
Where
what?
Where's the sandbox?
Well, I guess this whole thing is considered a sandbox, since you can just experiment to your heart's content and do whatever you want.
Well, you said there was a sandbox for us to play around in.
Well, that's just a general term they use for like an area for you to play around with. It's not an actual sandbox where you see sand.
I've never heard that term.
Okay. Well, now you have. It's a it's a term that's used quite frequently.
In video games?
In video games and just maybe even in software, different scenarios.
Well, both of those are very much unlikely for me to have heard.
All right, so now you know. So let's start here playing with some fireworks, right? Let's do it right here in the middle of the street. I think we should be okay. I'm not expecting any traffic right now, so let's open up our menu here. What happened?
And then a car just comes.
Yeah, knowing our luck, a big 18-wheeler will come and wipe us out before we even light our first firework. But hopefully that's not going to happen, right? So let's open up our menu here and see what do we got here for fireworks. So here on the left side, I guess there are different categories. So we got rockets.
Why is it a cake?
We got cakes. So I guess cakes in terminology for fireworks are just like a big, huge, maybe bundle of fireworks that many different fireworks come out of.
So a bomb.
Kind of like a bomb, I guess. Then we got firecrackers here, and these look like maybe just your typical little basic fireworks. Got some novelties here.
What's up with these names?
I don't know. I know the names sound kind of a little over the top in some cases, but I think it's just to kind of attract you to them. Especially when you go out to buy them, you know, you go to a little fireworks shop and you see something called, the Wand of Wizard, Santa was here, Insane Screamer, that just makes you want to buy it, right?
No.
The name? No? I mean, when I see that, I was like, yeah, I'll take 20 of them, please. I want 20 Insane Screamers.
Yeah, I'll take none of them.
You do not know the power of the firework yet.
Are they,
if you did, you'd want to buy a bunch of these.
Are they named after YouTubers?
What's
I
that?
I see two YouTuber names.
Yeah, I guess these are called tubes. I guess the type of firework that it is, you know, in a kind of a cylinder tube shape. I know what PewDiePie?
No, PewDiePie, right?
I think
that's,
so. Maybe
that's what he's
just
called. I don't know.
Mr.
That's what Mason
Beast
says?
Is it supposed to be like Mr. Beast or something?
Mr.
I don't
Beast.
Know. Maybe they're just kind of a play on some of these celebrity names of YouTubers.
Well, I have only heard two of them.
And then we got some props here as well, I guess. Propane tanks, that sounds pretty dangerous. I think we'll save those for the end here. Okay, so what do you want to start with? I'll let you choose. What kind of fireworks do you want to do here?
That one at the bottom.
The very bottom?
Yeah.
The World Stopper?
No.
The Viper 2, Viper, and the Thick Billy.
That one.
Okay, can you tell me a name? I can't exactly see what you're pointing at, so.
This Thick Billy, you know, in your.
Okay, alright. Alright, so once you have your fireworks selected, the left mouse button will kind of just drop it there on the floor, which is probably not always
not
the
safe.
Best direction, you know, where you want these things to go. With the, actually, sorry, I have it the wrong way. The right mouse button drops them on the ground. The left mouse button will kind of drop it there in place, so it's pointing straight up wherever you place it. So once you have them here placed, then we...
Can you put them upside down?
I think we could. With that physics tool, we can change the direction of how we want them to go. But by default, it goes straight up. So let's light this one here, right, with our igniter tool. Okay, so here it goes, and all right, away it goes.
Picked a good one.
That one was not bad, right? So these, if we lit them, they're just going to fly down the street. Let's go ahead and do those. One, and let's just see what that one can do. Whoa.
It's going to blow you up.
Yeah, that could potentially be bad if this was real life. Do not stand this close to your fireworks. Especially ones that fly, that could be unpleasant to say the least. But it did look cool though.
It's cooler in the sky.
Yeah, definitely, right? Because you can get more distance and this kind of has a bigger explosion up there. All right, so seems pretty easy to drop some of our fireworks here.
Can I try?
You want to try?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I will close the menu and give you the controls.
Can I jump in this game?
I don't think it has a jump yet. Maybe they'll add that in the future. It's still, as I mentioned, an early access game.
This thing runs around fast. How do I go into the select thing?
So the right bumper, or sorry, backwards today, the left bumper I currently have is selected for our fireworks menu. And when you see one that you want, you can push the right trigger. There you go.
Okay, so let's say I didn't pay attention to any of your explanations and don't know what's going on.
Okay, so now that you have your fireworks selected, if you push the right trigger, it will drop it on the ground. The left trigger will put it there in place and it'll be facing straight up. And you can put as many as you want. You can just keep pushing the same button and you can drop as many as you want to, or you can do a variety of different ones, as you are now here picking a different one. Yep. So what do you want to do now? Trying to light them?
No, try to put them together.
Oh, you want to put a fuse to make them together?
Yeah.
Okay, so hold down the right bumper, I believe. Yep, and then go up to the fuse.
Well, I had already picked it.
Okay, so now look at them. Go up, and you see that little glowing orange square on them?
Yeah.
Hold down the right trigger on the controller while you're pointing at one of those glowing squares, and then drag it. There you go. Yep, now they're connected. Okay, so now when you light either one of them, they're going to have like a chain reaction, and the other one will go after that one does.
Okay. Now to light this place.
Yep, just kind of point it. Yeah, there you go, and then back up. Here we go. The sky. Yeah, it sounded like it did something else, but I didn't see anything else. Hmm. Okay.
Like
some things you can't grab, yeah.
Well, can't get hurt in this game either.
No. Currently there is like no health to your character. I believe you are invincible. So hopefully this is not our house, because you are like destroying it at the moment, so the neighbors are going to come home to quite a mess, it seems.
Will we live in this town?
I don't know.
I thought you said it was abandoned.
I'm assuming it's abandoned.
Which one's the E button?
The E button, what does the E button do? Rotate?
Yeah.
You know, I think I have not actually programmed that one yet on the controller. So I'll have to take note of that and program that later.
Well, I got it to stand up. Now.
Okay. Okay, how about you let me give it a go? I want to make a big giant explosion. We'll come back to house redecorating here in just a few moments, maybe a later episode. We will come back and fully destroy this house properly. But let's kind of get back on track here. We are here to make a hopefully an impressive fireworks display. If anything, just a gigantic one, right? I mean, that's got to be impressive. The bigger you can make it, right? So let's make one out here.
Well, if you put two together and put them really close together.
Yeah. So let's get, I'm going to start down here at the bottom, right? These big ones, I'm assuming maybe the ones at the bottom are more powerful than the top ones. So let's start with a world stopper here. And I'm just going to make, I guess, like a line of these things, right? Because the more the merrier, right? Why wouldn't you want to do that?
With
an unlimited disposal of fireworks, you want to go crazy, right? Go big or go home. All right, let's put some of these.
Well, I guess I'm going home.
No, we're going to go big. Don't worry. Look at this. Look at this.
How are you going to set all this off?
It's going to be insane.
How if you can't set them off?
I'm gonna put a fuse on all of these, and it's gonna be
slow.
I don't think so.
Boring.
I doubt it.
You know, there's some of the same fireworks on the list, right?
What's that?
If you go down the list, there's some of the same ones. With the same names. Why do they do that? Also, why is the Chute Boy red? Looks blue.
I'm not sure. Let's put some of these thick billies here. Alright. I'm afraid to put too many because I'm not sure how long it's going to last. I mean, we don't want to be here for an hour watching fireworks. So let's kind of wrap this first one up. I do want to put a cake or two on here. Which one of these cakes looks interesting to you? Well, definitely end with a 2021 probably. But which one are these?
In the corner.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's put, I'm not sure how long this one's last, but four of those. And we'll end it with this 2021 cake to celebrate the new year. All right. So I'm gonna try and link all these together now. I want this one to be last though, so let me see if I can.
Have to start on that side.
Let's see.
You don't even know where you're connecting.
I guess I'm not too concerned about the order. I actually want to randomize it a little bit too. Just as long as most of them are connected, I think we'll be fine. Let's see here.
Not if you start unconnecting them.
I think this only connects them, I don't think it unconnects them. Alright, so... Okay.
Cakes.
These. And then finally we're gonna end with this 2021, hopefully. There we go. Alright. So... looking pretty ferocious. What do you think?
Just pick one to light.
I know. I'm gonna start part in this back corner and then I'm gonna back up and we'll check this out. So here we go. Hopefully it's impressive, everybody.
Hopefully they actually go off.
I think they will. Alright. Happy New Year's. High five.